Ladies and gentlemen, everything you're about to hear is 100% human voiced.
Hey, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. This is your B Raptures TV crew. You got myself, which is Mpapa, aka Kizaka Riva. You got Chester Mchestero.
Keenness 100.
On today's episode, we were asked to talk about our varsity experience. So,
and relationships.
Yeah. On that varsity experience. So today we'll be mainly focusing on those relationships that we have or had here on varsity. But before we tackle that issue or that main event, we have a couple of comments that they needed our attention as we asked for you guys to interact with us, as we say, comment. So this comment is from Kwazi Dlamini. He's asking, there are questions.
I wonder.
And he asked special that do not answer me now, but in the next video.
Which is this one.
So we are answering his question. His first question says, what inspired the monetization of B-Raptures TV? Would you say you are still sticking? Hey, yes, what's up? Would you say you are still sticking yet to reach all already where you first aspired to be when you first started? So this first question, what inspired our monetization is? Oh, initially we didn't know that we are already monetized there on YouTube. Because
we didn't like monetize.
So yeah, basically we can't get into details about monetization because we don't know much about monetization. So we just kind of see, we didn't know that our channel is already monetized. So are we where we aspire to be, or we are still reaching?
No, personally I feel like we are not where we wanted to be in YouTube. Because when we started this thing, we wanted to reach at least 100k. I don't know. I mean 1k. At least, at least 1k subscribers, even views. But still, even now we haven't reached that level. So
We're still getting there.
We're probably outbreak by the break which we took.
So the second question is saying, will the channel still be functional after university?
Until we die, apparently. This channel, this Perhaps just it's forever. It's forever, man.
So he's also asking for the viewers out there, if they want to join the crew.
What do you mean join? Are you saying join or feature?
Join or feature? Either or.
We can't talk about joining because.
So what about the feature then?
But then we can talk about the feature. So basically, here's what is required for you to be featured by us. We are not acting as if like we are popular or whatnot, but we have our own standards and our own
values
and all those kind of things. So we are saying, for you to be featured by us, you must have at least 100 subscribers on your channel.
Which is fair.
It's fair.
Since we are a startup crew. But we can't verify.
And also if we see that you at least like personally yourself, like you have the thing, that thing you qualify to be here, then maybe we'll feature you.
So we don't need a CV basically.
Just come, we'll analyze you, talk to you.
We'll talk. And then even when we click talk, we can work something out.
And then we'll talk, we'll drop a contract for the feature.
So on today's menu then, we're talking about varsity experience, mainly we wanna tackle this relationship thing.
This thing's of relationship.
Hey, this thing of
actually, relationship. This name of sheeps.
Hey,
yes, John.
Yeah, yeah, man.
The relationships and the friendship.
Yeah.
Is it the same as joy?
Relationship it's
somewhere along those
lines. Yeah.
Somewhere along those lines.
Because I think there's some misconception in China between the two.
Relationship and joy.
Yeah.
We have in China, I'm hearing two different languages.
On the same thing.
I don't know. Me, I'm just hearing.
But in China, when you like having many entanglements or relationships in China, they say they are joy.
But wait.
But in China, they if maybe like you are in those many relationships, they can't say you are in many relationships or you are in relationships.
So for you, a relationship is mainly being with a lot of people.
No. Only one, John.
But is that when you have those?
You see, Chana, the thing that I started with is the difference between umjolo and a relationship. Is there such a difference, Chana, or
so what is what is a relationship in Vene?
Umtanda. Yeah.
And then to love.
Umtanda.
Being in love.
Being in love.
I stopped loving you, John. Okay, fine.
Okay.
So, we're gonna talk about the varsity experience. So.
Yeah, guys, okay, let me just ask you the first question to kick off this whole thing. So, how was your first experience like? Talk about your first experiences.
Maybe, like, it.
Maybe on the first day that you came here. Let me
break the ice of university experience. First time I came here, I arrived a bit late in college. And then we were there.
What do you mean late? Isn't like 8 o'clock when you're supposed to be there at 7?
Yeah, I was supposed to be there at 8. I was here at main campus at 8. So the lectures begin like 8 o'clock. But I was not near the lecture room by 8 o'clock.
Why?
I'm an estimator, bro.
Oh.
Yeah. So I was traveling on my first day, so I was using estimate, aka the train. So, yeah. So when I got there, I didn't know where campus was looking at or what. So when I got there, the timetable for the first period, it said TBA. I thought the venue is TBA. Yeah, so that's why I met Mr. Somebody, Madala Sambu police there. So yeah, I asked this person, I was like, hey, free to. Why is this TBA? You know? And he's also like, TBA.
I'm also looking for
TBA. Oh, by disclaimer, TBA is to be announced.
Oh, it's an abbreviation.
Yeah, it's an abbreviation for to be announced. So I'm busy looking for to be announced.
Also, basically under the venue part, they wrote to TBA.
So I'm busy wondering, what is this TBA?
Wow,
now? So hey, that was my first edge. So yeah, from there, I met people, befriended these clowns, and then, yeah. Here we are. Just
yo, my first experience. My roommate.
The first thing you tell about is a roommate in China.
Yeah.
Like in China, what happened at school in China?
You got here for the orientation, nigga.
Yo, orientation, I was too smart for that shit, man. Okay, let me see. Bro, first experience. Yo. What was yours in China? Maybe I don't remember mine.
Okay, in China, mine was, hey. It was a bit simple. and a bit complicated too. Because in China, I on my first days in China, you see. So in China, I shouldn't have mentioned that. So in China, I was seeing people in China, like walking around Bloemfontein in China. Anytime in China, I was like, hey, China here, it's nice. Like people just walk in China at night, anytime. Okay. And I was staying in China around by APP UJ.
You see
what happened there.
Yeah.
Where? In Oksondong. I was walking by in Oksondong. You see. So China, while I was walking there,
in Oksondong
at that street, China by K10.
Oh, the name of the street.
Yeah. So it was in Oksondong Avenue, you see. So I was walking there in China, 12:30 at night. I'm walking there, hey, there's this other guy in China. He's like, you know, Natasha from Stum. Yeah, was holding the stick then. I'm walking towards me in China. I said, hey, in China, there were two of them in China. Hey.
So you saw two Natashas?
Okay, there was only one in China, and the other one was not carrying anything. He was just running. In China, I ran away in China. When I got to that side in China, I saw like other two niggas in China coming there. Tried to dodge them in China, but they catched me. And luckily in China, there was a car to save me there and rescue me in China. Hey, they hit me with the stick there. China was traumatized that day. I was like, yo, I'm never walking back to that campus at night. So in China, I was affected in a way in China because I couldn't spend enough time in school and I had to like walk home early.
Just from Lakash.
Yeah, in China, because of Lakash.
Okay, guys, let me go back to my experience and talk about dress. So guys, at dress, I was staying at men's dress, so you know, during orientation day, they make us sing and do all those kind of things, initiation, on a busy day, sing. So basically, this one time, they told us to like go outside, you know, just feeling our point about it too. We sang, chief. We said, in China, I could feel what's normal. My voice now is charming. This thing of singing, this thing is gonna charm my voice. So, in China, while they were singing there, me, I was quiet. Then, you know, senior says in China. They are busy there in China. Some are watching in China. Some in China, So, in China, this one senior says in China, so, what's normal? Me, Chester is not singing. Hey, China, that song came to me in China,
you know? You know,
yeah. China, why are you not singing, dude? My voice is charming. My voice is charming. Hey, China, I was refusing to sing in China, and then they decided to go to one tart, and it took me, chief. There's a dustbin there in China, outside there in China. Yeah. And in China, obviously, they had trash inside in China. So China, you told me China, to go inside there in China. Plus you see me, I'm short in China. To go inside there in China, and stand up in China. And say, oh, I'm rubbish. With your child voice. Hey China. I was there in China. I'm rubbish. Say, what are you? I am rubbish. Hey China, so basically I did.
You're 60.
But I'm not rubbish, by the way, because yeah, so that was my first question to you, Liz. So you confessed that you were rubbish, so
yeah.
No, I'm trying to, they made me do it. They made me do it, so yeah, confirmation of the life search. Guys, I don't like where this thing is going. This topic is making me paranoid. So now we move into the relationship part, yeah? So I wanna know, how many relationships have you had
hell with.
Zero. I've had some entanglements and then some. I can't even call them relationships because they lasted like not necessarily one year. You know, Mchana, if it lasted less than a month.
Yeah. So Mchana, you were entangling or they were entangling you?
I was entangled and I was entangling. Or entangling. Yeah, whatever. Yeah. So
okay.
So me myself, I don't think.
So basically, it's me. Many entanglements.
Many relationships. Entanglements. Yeah, like that.
So,
he wasn't in a spider web there. He was in tingling things. Yeah. What about you?
Yeah, so
then I was just missing out.
So you don't want to confirm the number?
John, I'm saying I was just feeling them.
Yeah, it's fine. Yeah.
There was no relationship.
No, there's no harm.
There was no relationship.
How many people
so there's like,
so my answer to the thing is zero. So just easy.
So basically there's cause and intercourse. So we are looking at that intercourse. Yeah, you know.
Steve, you can improve on that.
Alright. Steve.
Apparently in China it was only one.
Relationship.
Yeah.
Why? So no entanglements. Okay, one relationship. What about the
Yes, let's talk about relationships. Be honest, each other. Talk about relationships and be honest, completely honest.
It's one, Jana. And you all know it. It was one.
Which one?
That's why.
Yeah.
Niggas, you said you're gonna be honest.
Yeah, John.
See!
Okay, it was not like a relationship and like some.
No names.
Connections there.
Name and shame.
No, don't shame people.
No, John.
It's not a shame.
I'm joking.
Yeah. So, one relationship.
Yeah, and
what about entanglement?
So, basically, you're not a loyal person yourself.
I am, John. Mchana, I had entanglements while I was not in a relationship.
Okay. Mchana.
But I think I am.
What's neat? Hi. Okay.
Baba?
Relationships? Hi. Not really. Okay. Now you put in entanglement. I don't know what a pure definition of entanglement. But for me, it's relationships. Not more than 10, not less than 6. Between that range, I'm not sure how.
Not more than 10.
Not less than 6. Six.
Yeah.
Between 6 and 10.
6, 7, 8, 9, and 10.
Mm.
Either those numbers.
No! Meaning was 9. But, you see.
Can't be 10.
No. Because between 6 and 10.
Yeah, it's not more than 10, it's 10.
But I'm sure
you guys had entanglement. That's what I'm saying. I can't put myself in those entanglements moment. Because you know.
Relationships, everyone has been dating.
So, yes, I've been in dating. I'm welcoming.
So, niggas, I want to know something. How were you coping with those entanglements?
Me, relationships.
Oh, relationships, yeah.
Chief, me. Let me just.
Did you have like many at the same time, or it was one at a time?
Nah, if you're just having fun, there's no need to label them. Oh, this is 1, 2, 3. Mm. You just.
So Jana, how did you cope like with all of them? And
yeah.
Did they know
that they are in an entanglement, or were they thinking that, you know what, hey, can I let you explain it? Hey. Put their
hands. It is what it is.
Yeah.
Chief, me what I know is that
they are in that entanglement, were you verbalizing it like, okay, fine. What we have.
No, Mchana, here's what I did. I never said anything about relationship and love.
Yeah, that's what I'm asking.
So if I say such, when I was with her, I would put it.
Wait, you said, okay, you said you have entanglement, no relationship.
Yeah.
My question is,
let me just say,
was it the thing you internalized and you said, you know what, I've been in entanglement. I mean, everyone thought that they're busy catching feelings.
But you killed my
expectations. And then, what did I say?
I'm asking you a question. Repeat.
I told you, I'm sure one day it's about love and relationships. So it means maybe I will, like, automatically do something. Maybe they didn't know. But I think they knew. They knew.
How? What made them know?
Because I never asked them to be in a relationship.
Oh, so they know what's like, okay, Chester, we meet, then we chow, then we go.
Yeah, maybe a week, and then we just mess around for a week, and then...
Right.
Maybe one day.
Mm. Okay, that's nice. Oh. That's how you cool. You knew that contract is 1 week, 1 day, 1 night, 2 hours, and that's it.
Guys, this topic is making me hallucinate.
But okay. For my side, it's not that much a thing. Because it was one at the time. Mm. So when one is there, then I stick to one person. When it ends with that one person, then I move on to the next one. Mm. So So it was not that much hectic for my side. That's how I managed to cope with everything. What about you, Steve?
John. My side, apparently it was coping with John. I was able to cope through that relationship when I had it.
Yeah.
And when it was not in China, I could cope with these entanglements in China and manage them well. Keep myself healthy also.
So is it not so in those entanglements, were you guys were all about sex, or did you guys have like go out to eat somewhere, do those sweet nyana things?
Sex.